Welcome back to the channel, everybody. This week, we've got something very exciting. OpenAI have produced a brand new piece of kit. It's called Agent. And if you think about operator and deep research, I'll put the videos up here. So operator and deep research had a baby, and that baby is called Agent. Let's jump in and have a look. It's very cool. Okay, so here I am in ChatGPT. I'm in 03. And if you go down to tools, you will see a new mode, agent mode. Now, I have the pro plan, and that means you get 400 credits. I've got 398 left because I've had a little play. So you get 400 credits, and one credit is one request to the agent. So unlike some of the other agentic tools that are out there, it's not based on the size of the pie, but it is it's one request, and that takes one tool. So 398 a month, that's a lot on the pro plan. I think you get 40 on the standard plan, on the $20 a month plan. I think you get 40 on the $20 a month plan. But let's jump in and let's have a play and see what it can do. Okay, so what I've said, my first prompt is look at my inbox and brief me on any business opportunities in there. For each client, add three bullet points of detail, what they're asking and what I either need to send them or I'm waiting on. Go back 7 days. Let's see what we get. So we need to turn on agent mode. Da, 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 da. And let's go. Let's see what we get. So a bit like Manus, it spins up a desktop and it then sets it up, goes in and it will give you information. So looking at the web page, trying to open my Gmail through the browser, we'll see whether it asks me to sign in. I have signed in before on operator, so that might work. Let's see where we get to. So it's getting network errors. Site can't be reached. So what I expect it to do is stop in a moment, say, can you log into your Gmail? So it's testing a lot of things. Now, what you can do is you can just jump in. It's trying lots of things. And so I can say, stop. I can log to my Gmail for you. So like with Manus, you can just jump in and give it additional instructions, and it will stop and then it will come back again. Okay. All right. Please go ahead and log into your Gmail in this browser window. Once you've signed in, you can in and have your inbox open. Let me know and I can proceed. So continue. It should give me a browser window, I think. Takes a little bit of time. There we go. You click in this. Nothing on my network. Take control. So you're about to take control and it tells you that ChatGPT won't take screenshots. So if I enter my password, it won't take that. Your browser session will be saved and this may put any data at risk. So one of the things that will come up a number of times is that OpenAI, Sam Altman, when he did his video, talked quite a lot about safety. This is new. This may generate new threats. So there's quite a lot of guardrails in, particularly at the particular time. So I understand. There we go. Put in my password. Should work. Two-step verification. There we go. I'll try the Google authentication app. Burnout for my two-factor authentication. Bane of my life. See? Hurrah. I'm in. I can finish controlling now. So it now has access to my emails and it can carry on with its activity. See where we get to. So ChatGPT is working with mail, google.com, which contains sensitive data. If you notice anything bad happening, you can stop the task. It gives you a stop agent. It's reading my emails and it's working out which ones are business opportunities, which ones aren't. We'll see what we get in terms of a report. And it takes a bit of time. There's a lot of emails in there. It's looking for important emails. We'll come back when it's done. Okay, so it's still working. Going through, reading my emails. And it's reviewing the promotional emails, etc. And it's produced a summary of the genuine business-related opportunities that appear in your inbox. And here's one with Wizard AI. And I've been invited to join the affiliate. I'm going to be doing a video on it in a few days. And the actions that I need to do, Spreadshirt, Dropbox invited me to participate in a short research survey about digital habits. I'll earn a £10 gift card, Artlist, ChatGPT connector, Ahrefs, and if that's how it's pronounced, Perplexity. I've got informed me that I was on the wait list for Comet, YouTube creator community, and some Spreadshirt marketing tips. So really cool. Went through my inbox, created a whole load of information, even gives me access to the emails. Let's close that so I can actually jump in and see the exact emails. Takes me to Gmail. There I've got my inbox business briefing. Very cool. Now, you could probably do that yourself, but I think you've been away for a couple of days. You want to get Agent to go through it for you so you don't miss any opportunities. Great. I get hundreds of emails. This has been through, searched through hundreds and picked out the ones that are important to me. Very cool. Let's move on. Okay, so for this demonstration, I want to see if it can do some competitor analysis and if it can do sort of SWOT analysis. So that's more deep research than operator. I think the last one was much more operator wise. So it was going through effectively a website and checking things, doing the reading. And then can it create slides? So I've said, analyze three competitors in the AI strategic business advice market in the UK and create a 10-slide Google slide deck that's editable with a SWOT for each. The title slide is Business Consultancy for AI in the UK, creating engaging and relevant images for each slide. So make sure that agent mode is on. I could, of course, I've got web search on, but I could, of course, also link GitHub and other documents. So if I had my own documents in my Google Drive, they can be also added, etc. So let's set this going and I will be back when it's done. Okay, we're back. It took, wait for this, 53 minutes to produce this slide deck. Let's have a look at what we've actually got. We'll probably blow this up. So it's created pictures. Let's have a look at the slide deck. Some contents. Sure, that's massively best. AI could be around 630 million to the UK economy. So I think if I was doing this, I'd want to, well, I would probably put it into Gamma and say, smarten this up. But AI adoption gap. So it's found some data, faculty AI, some strengths and some weaknesses. I've done a video on faculty AI, I'm sure. No, maybe I haven't. Maybe just faculty. Faculty AI, opportunities, threats, Cambridge consultants, some strengths and weaknesses. There we go. Quantum Black, strengths and weaknesses, part of McKinsey. Originated in Formula One racing. Premium pricing, lengthy strategy phase. Opportunities, expanding UK market, comparative insights, conclusion, client focus, public sector and regulated, bespoke R&D innovators, large enterprises, so for the three, key strength, ethical AI, public sector links, deep science and product creation, hybrid intelligence at scale, main weaknesses, reliance on government, low brand, high cost and long cycles, premium and complex programs, opportunities, ethics, robotics, agentic AI, best suited for regulated mission, deep tech innovators, strategic transformations. Okay. So, maybe not the greatest slide deck I've ever seen, but it's done the research. It's done a SWOT analysis. It took 50 odd minutes to do it, which is a long time. 53 minutes to do it. Pretty good. Would Manus have done it better? Perhaps. All right, let's move on. Okay, so this time we're going to... So we know that for Operator, it was very good at doing travel type stuff. So let's test this out again using our beautiful agent mode. And I've said plan a 5-day Lisbon trip from London for under 1,500 euros. Include flights, a 3-star hotel in Baxia, and 3 local experiences. Hold any bookings and ask before any payment. So as Sam said multiple times, just be careful with this technology. Giving it your credit card, letting it go out. You know, will there be a website created that will take your credit card and then empty your bank account? We don't know. These are new tools and I think you need to be careful. I think that's right. Let's set this one going. Hopefully it won't take 53 minutes because it's still hot here in the UK and in my office it's particularly hot. Anyway, it's getting going. Okay, so one of the cool things you can do, you can have multiple activities going on at the same time. So my Lisbon trip is still planning, still doing its stuff. And what I can do is go into a new chat. And what I want to do is say, what I've done is created some dummy data for a company. And I have said, create an interactive web page based on the attached data file, which is this one. Analyze the data and draw conclusions. So I've got agent on. Let's set that one going. So that's going. It's got the data. And just to show you that we are still planning our trip to Lisbon. Oh, no, we've got our trip to Lisbon. It's done it. So that didn't take very long. Let's have a look. It took about 5 minutes. All right, let's have a look what Lisbon is doing while we are creating our web page. Work for 5 minutes. Here's a draft of a 5-day break in Lisbon, assuming Tuesday the 12th of August, Saturday the 16th of August. Get the budget under 1,500 euros. Here's the options. Flights, non-stop economy from Gatwick to Lisbon, 120 euros. Hotel in Baxia. I don't know if that's how it's pronounced. 460 for 4 nights. Lisbon Airport is 6 kilometres from Baxia. Taxi or Uber will take cost about 10 to 15 euros each way. Suggested experience. Fado show. 1 hour live Fado performance. One of the best ways to hear Portugal's UNESCO listed music. Day trip to Sintra. Pastel de Nata baking class. Now, I love pastel de Nata. They are maybe my favourite thing. So going and learning how to bake them, that'll be well worth it. An itinerary. I think Mrs. Professor will enjoy this. Flights. Cool. If you're happy with this plan and the assumed dates, I can proceed on holding the flights and hotel. No payment yet. Secure tickets for the experience. So I could now say, yeah, go and find the hotels, hold the rooms. It will go off. Make some bookings. It'll probably use booking.com. Don't want it to do that. But anyway, shows you what it can do. Let's have a look at the web page creation. Still working. Creating some code there for the web. It's doing some analysis of the retail data that I've got. Working through. Created some code. Very cool. So it's spinning up code. Ready to do the activity. Let's come back when it's complete, see whether we get a interesting web page that's interactive. Let's see what we get. See you in a minute. Okay, I'm surprised it took 3 minutes. So while I got the other bit loaded, it took 3 minutes to do this, and I've got a HTML file. We have a look and see if we've actually got a page. So now it's going to work. Will it just run? Ooh, this looks a bit Interactive dashboard, analyze a small data set. Is it really interactive? So jackets. I don't know what's going on here. Does it change the data? It does. Units sold. So it does, but it creates this slightly concerning shakiness in the interactive piece. Let's have a look, see if we can increase the entries to 20. Whoa, UK online. Right, so it's created an interactive dashboard, but it's shaky. Not so bad. Not so good. Cool. All right, so that is Agent. Now, is it as good as Manus yet? I don't think it is. I think Manus is more stable, it's got more tools, etc. But this is a proper competitor. It will only get better. It's been out a day. I got this yesterday. It's been out a day. You've got loads of, certainly on the pro plan, 400 opportunities to work with it. I'm sure that it will get better. Even 40 is a lot. I think doing 40 requests on Manus, you probably need to have a higher level of account. So it's interesting. It's cool. I'm not sure it's quite there yet, but it's something I will certainly be keeping an eye on, and I'll do some more videos later to test it out even more. If you've enjoyed the video, then don't forget to drop me a like and hit subscribe and ring the bell, and you'll be told whenever I make a new video. Hope you've enjoyed it. I've been the professor. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye for now.